But that's not gonna happen this year.
All right, we're ready to come to order for our open meeting at an executive session. We're all here except for Jill, who is excused. This is agendas you're passing around? Okay, thanks. And our first order of business, as usual, is approval of the agenda that I sent out a few days ago. I take it, Barry, that you're moving to approve the agenda as distributed?
I'll second it.
So it's moved by Barry Samuels and seconded by Barry Miller to approve the agenda. Any further discussion? All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay? The motion carries. Thanks. The next item on the agenda is I'd like to appoint Jill Fisher as the chair of the building committee.
Great.
She asked to be...
While she's not here.
That's right. She's not here, but she did leave an email to me saying that she would like to.
Good.
And...
You put us at ease there. You're afraid you go on vacation.
You should be.
And, yeah, if you don't, if you go on vacation and don't leave an email requesting, don't think. But we have a number of building and grounds issues looking at us for the rest of the year, and so it seemed to me like a good idea to get somebody in that position. So if there's no objection, then that would be my appointment. The next item is the approval of the minutes of three meetings. Let's take them one at a time. The first one was our regular meeting in July, where we approved the budget. A regular but important meeting. The minutes have been out for a few days. I was a little late in sending them out. I'm sorry for that, but they're out now and have been for a few days, and I think they're on the web. And so I would entertain a motion to approve them.
I'll make a motion.
Or change it. Okay, so it's moved by Caroline.
Second.
Seconded by Barry Miller to approve the minutes of the meeting of July 16th as distributed. Is there any discussion? All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay? The motion carries. How about the special meeting of July 29th? Those minutes went out, too, a few days ago.
I'll make a motion to approve those.
Thanks. So moved by Barry Miller, seconded by Barry Samuels to approve the minutes of July 29th. Any further discussion? All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed, nay? The motion carries. And the meeting of July 30th, special meeting. Anyone care to move to approve those?
I'll make a motion to approve it.
Okay, thank you.
Awesome.
Oh, good. And so we have the same. Barry Miller moves, Barry Samuel seconds.
That makes it simple.
Mm-hmm. To approve the minutes of the meeting of July 30th. Any further discussion? All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay? The motion carries. The next item won't go quite so fast. It's the financial report.
I'm passing it all out. It's double-sided for the trees.
Uh-huh, good. And so it's stapled together. One,
it is.
One stapled package is the full report.
Oh, did I not take double-sided?
Hmm? Are you looking for that?
Oh, no, wait. No, wait, you're good. We're
it's
good.
On the back page. Of
I
the...
have the one that's not double-sided. Oh. That's all.
Would you like, would you like one? Or you have the,
I have the,
you have the resolution elsewhere. Okay.
Yep.
Is accrual basis the program that you use to do the books?
No, there's two different kinds of bookkeeping. Cash basis and accrual basis.
Ah.
And it's possible that QuickBooks is the program he uses. I don't
know. Well, I said that because I saw it.
Right,
because
they're on accrual basis.
I didn't know what that was.
Okay. Jessica, would you like to lead us through this?
The first page you're looking at is the capital findings. And that's... We haven't done anything yet.
And this is the separate fund, which is the designated funds, which I reported at the last meeting, or that we're not going to have to return any to the state if we amend our narrative and do the work before the beginning, or before the middle of next year, of taking down the building across the street. And looks as though there's enough money here to do that.
The next page is the general funds. The main changes have been the operating funds. We've been paying our bills.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Yeah. There was a question, I don't remember from who, last time, comparing this here, the total of the assigned funds, which continue. The total about partway through the page here, assigned funds, this amount.
56,507.
You got it. And then on the next page, the equity, it appears again here, and the numbers are slightly different. That is due to interest that is accrued and is put into the net income account, and at the end of the year is balanced by the accountants. So it's not, and a little bit of it is rounding, but that is what the difference is. Not.
Terrific. We're getting. So, any questions about this aspect of it? The library's position.
I know the balance in the compensated absences fund came up at the last meeting, and I think we're going to be talking about that more later on, so
yeah.
I'll hold questions.
Well, we're going to put enough into the compensated absences to compensate the absences that we paid out.
That we compensated.
Uh-huh. So we're going to
And also that line, the AO234A, was previously called uncompensated absences and wasn't fixed, but now is fixed, so all of the accounts have the proper, proper names.
Thanks.
Does anyone have any other questions about that? Anything? We could go to the budget versus actual.
Mm-hmm. Anything you want to call our attention to on this?
We are going to talk about, again, the
compensated absences line that's 939% of budget.
You got it.
We'll deal with that.
I have yet to get which one is it? The programs line under other expenses, which is about the third page of the budget versus actual. Because I missed the last Friends meeting, we're going to discuss that cost of programming being sorted out at the next one.
So some Friends might contribute some and bring down that.
Right.
But still, the overall other expenses is still about where it should be.
Right. Again, we're a little bit higher on the bookkeeping than we'd like for where we are in the year, but that's because it's been a little bit more sorting out. We've gotten, I asked him about our accountants about this, we've gotten to where they're pretty comfortable, and we're going to get back on our usual schedule and as planned.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any further questions or comments about budget versus actual? Well,
yeah, I have a question.
Go ahead.
On page 204, compensated absences, it says percent of budget, 939.46%. But it's not over budget. I'm not understanding.
The second column in the four is our budget for 2015, and that's $5,000 we planned on in the compensated absences, and what we've spent is $46,972. So the comparison is $5,000 to $46,000, so it's a lot more than we planned.
And this could be a moment to amend the budget, which there's a resolution, a draft resolution on the back of a package to amend the budget to bring it back into line. Which, want to explain what this does?
What this does is increases our compensated absences line to balance the payouts, and we'll do that by moving the $13,051 from the compensated absences that we had put in reserve in the last several years.
The assigned unappropriated reserve for compensated absences.
Got it. And the additional monies, the $28,922, will come from the unassigned funds. These costs have already been paid. We're just
Adjusting the budget. The 2014 budget.
No, the 2015.
2015 budget, right.
Yep.
So, does that make sense? And does anybody want to move this, a budget amendment?
I'll make a motion to move. Do you want me to state it as written?
I think it's enough that it move the resolution as written.
Right, okay. Okay, so I make a motion to make the change as written to increase our compensated absences.
Is there a second?
I second.
Thank you, Doris. Is there a discussion? Does this seem sensible? All in favor, aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. The motion carries. Thank you. And thank you, Jessica, for getting that. So the next time we see this report, it'll be 100%.
Right. You got it.
The expenses will match the budget amount. Thanks. Any more questions about this, or should we go on to checks and vouchers? You have a question.
Well, I didn't. Doris asked me a question earlier. Did you want to ask that question now?
Just, I didn't want to ask it now. But
okay.
So don't.
Okay, I won't.
All right. So I think we're ready to move on to checks and vouchers.
There are four pages of checks and vouchers.
Anything you want to call our attention to?
There's supplies and materials, regular bill paying, electric. The last month, our check for Time Warner Cable was not cut properly. The numbers were wrong, so this numbers are a little bit higher than usual in accounting for that, but that's all. The New York State unemployment insurance is a cost from New York State unemployment because they had been charging interest on unemployment insurance that they had
to the federal government.
Right.
They have to pay interest to the federal government.
So that's what that 702 is.
Jeez.
And we don't get a choice in that.
Nope.
Sounds like you've run into that too, Caroline.
Anybody who's paying unemployment insurance has to do it. Yep.
What did Shokan Electric do?
They installed some grounded outlets so we could better run the library fair and not burn the library down.
That was a good idea.
Yeah.
Nice move.
The Woodstock lock and safe charges are for making new keys when we had the sidewalk repair done.
Towards the end, their professional fees to like four people, they got $150 each, like Renee Englander and...
Those are election inspectors.
Ah.
So okay. Our checks are ready, but I will not give them to them until they come and inspect our election.
Uh-huh. Okay, great. Thank you.
I'm just curious, I don't see it on here. I know Roger was working outside on the roof by the barn.
Yes. There's several charges for Roger and also for Philip Levine.
Oh,
they, on the page 3 or 4, Roger and Amy worked up a plan to repair the back roof back there that overhangs.
The overhead.
Yep, that was leaking. They determined that they could do it for less than having a roofer do it. And they've completed the job and it's rained a couple times and seems good, so... We're pleased with that. There is two numbers for Philip Levine's check because there was two pages and my accountant only saw one, so we wrote a second check, handwritten. That's why it's the 101 check to cover work that he had done.
Mm-hmm.
And so he didn't have to wait till next month.
I see a second voucher number, which could be a typo.
They're both on the same voucher.
So this voucher 15429 really should have been 249. Probably.
No.
That's probably just a typo then if they're both on the same voucher.
Unless that's the next one. Yeah, it's a typo.
But yeah, and it should be the
49.
They're
going in
order. 249.
Yeah,
all right.
You are correct.
Well, I'm thinking about when we approve payment of numbered vouchers, the easy way is from the highest to the lowest to the highest.
Yeah.
So, any more conversation? Anything more you want to tell us or do you want to ask Jessica?
I'm glad to see the Young Adult Literature Symposium staff education.
Yes, Leslie, I offered... our budget accounts for staff education and conferences, and she's going to a young adult literature symposium, which is going to be great, and it's for at least a couple days, and also another staff education for the Ulster County Library Association. All of my staff are going to go to the annual dinner and talk.
Oh, great.
They highly deserve.
Not the one we were talking about.
Yes,
The UCLA one.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Cool.
Yes.
So all the whole staff.
Yep.
Is, but not
That's
you.
Great. Oh yes.
Oh, okay. All right. Great.
Okay. Great.
Yes.
And it's going to be a good talk. It's the Prison Project. From Howard. Yeah. That should be interesting.
So I entertain a resolution to approve vouchers number 15221 through 15263, if we're ready to do that.
I move.
Thanks, Dorothea. Is there a second? So it's moved by Dorothea and seconded by Barry Miller to approve that string of vouchers. Any further discussion? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The motion carries. Any further discussion about the treasurer's, the financial report? I don't think we approve the financial report. We just accept it. Thank you. Oh, moving on to the director's report. What's new, Jessica?
You've been busy. I told you about the firm chairs, or the new chairs that the friends purchased. They are here. A couple of you sat in them. Mm-hmm. Nick is sitting in one now. And they're not bad.
Yeah, they're very comfortable.
Yeah, they seem sturdy. Mm-hmm. Our summer reading program has been going well. 210 children participated in programs and workshops so far. Leslie also did two programs for the summer rec program, which she does every year for 70 kids, 35 at a time.
Phew.
Luckily. Mm-hmm. 78 kids are working on their summer reading logs, and 20 have already completed their goals and picked up
t-shirts. That's so cute.
And in addition to that, kids have the opportunity to get their picture taken, and there's several of these flying in the children's room, especially mm-hmm. with the air conditioning. So it says, I'm a hero for reading, and this child read 30 days this summer.
Mm-hmm.
So that's new and fun. Kids mm-hmm. are enjoying that.
Is that the program where they choose what their goal is going to be?
Yeah.
And then when they achieve their goal, they get their picture on a pixie or something.
Yeah. A superhero.
A superhero. How can I?
Obviously.
Or whatever. We've got a shadow puppet workshop. The summer dance intensive workshop was this week, which was lots of fun. And the end of the summer reading program, picnic at 5 p.m. and film at 6 have been moved to September 1st to better drum up attendance mm-hmm. from busy families that have the first day of school on the 3rd.
It's interesting. I never knew the school could start before Labor Day.
It's Labor Day's been
and it's
a little
the day of the library election, too.
Yeah.
Mm, it starts on the 3rd.
Yeah. Yeah.
Labor Day is late this year.
Yeah.
Yes.
So as late as it can be.
We have switched waste removal companies and now use County Waste and Recycling. They have not a fee for every time you look at them or talk to them, which is nice. The other thing is that we're under the OGS pricing for Ulster County, which is the 2014 rate, because the state has not finalized pricing for 2015, when the state can do many things. Maybe we'll get it before 2016. So that's exciting. We've got now two dumpster-looking devices in the back. One of them is for garbage, and one of them is now for single-stream recycling, so it doesn't have to be sorted out. And the other nice thing is that the books that we either discard from the collection because they're damaged or broken, or the library, the book barn receives and are not in exhalable condition, we can recycle them without tearing their covers off as we used to.
That's great.
So it's great. I'm going to have some more recycle bins around the library so patrons and staff can more easily recycle.
Good.
But we're going to have... I'm excited about
all
it.
All good things.
It's all good.
And saving money.
And saving money.
Nice going, Jessica. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The policy manual has been updated to reflect the sick leave policy that we approved last meeting and is on the website. I told you about the summer youth employment program person last time that's completed. We wish we could keep him. We're looking forward to next year. Again, that's the program where they place a youth and pay for their wages, but they work for us. You all know that the budget vote and trustee election is coming up. Legal notices have been placed, absentee ballots have been created and mailed out. Doris helped me with that, stuffing envelopes, which was great. Election inspectors have been confirmed, and as you can see, their checks have been cut, but not given. budget information is available online and in the library at the bulletin board in the art books room, so patrons can peruse it at their leisure. There's also reminder slips there and at the circulation desk for folks to save the date. And there will also be a book sale from 4 to 7 on Election Day.
No,
I've been doing it for several years, but it's cool. Good.
Yeah.
And it'll also be Saturday.
It would be even better if we have a poster at the book sale on Election Day telling book buyers that there's also an election going on.
The
first year we did that, they forgot to put the poster up. I went out once and there was somebody buying a book who had no idea there was an election going on, too.
I will remember that.
Well, that was just at the beginning.
Yeah.
Not everything works right the first time.
Yeah. Tell people if they vote, they get a free book.
The estimates are all in for the asbestos removal. We've got a wide range. I would like to go ahead and schedule the work for the asbestos removal at the 6th Library Lane with DNS abatement for their competitive bid at $4,500, which also requires an independent air quality testing be done at the same time and can be provided by Quest Quality Environmental Solutions and Technologies, and would both be paid for out of the grant monies, which we need to spend. I have not yet gotten quotes. I hope to work with Jill on this and getting the demolition quotes and what exactly we can do with that space. But I'm looking forward to making progress on removing asbestos. And
there's quite a range from 12,000 to 4,500. What did the other people offer that was 12,000 that $4,500 didn't offer? I'm just curious.
It didn't quite.
They were offering the same services.
Kind of, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I'm not going to say they're not different, but without doing each of them, which we're not going to do, but we have the quotes if you'd like to review them. We can. V-Dry Systems also came, Bill Henkins, who was here in 1999. He remembered our basement.
Excuse me, before we go to that, I wonder if we need to approve the 4,500 or the 5,000, whatever it is. I can't remember what the threshold is.
5,000, so technically you don't.
Okay.
Combined, maybe?
Well, how about if we give you a motion to approve that, if that's the board's pleasure, to approve going ahead with the asbestos abatement the way Jessica has proposed?
I'll make a motion to go ahead with the...
Okay, thanks, Barry. Is there a second? So it's moved by Barry and seconded by Dorothea to approve with going ahead. Any further discussion? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The motion carries. Thanks. So that's great. You think it'll be done this month?
Not this month. I haven't...
It's a week left then.
Right. What, are we sitting around? I imagine that it could be scheduled in September.
True. So, now on to B-Dry.
Now B-Dry. Our basement's mainly the same as it was since 1999.
But the estimate is more.
It was about... Yep. Twice as much, which is what I guessed.
Does it come with any kind of warranty?
Yeah, 100% warranty. He really sat down and described the whole process, has a binder of examples and step-by-step pictures. He is also happy to come and do a presentation to the board at any time. The other thing about their company is that they'll do the work up front and get paid after, when we're happy. But that is a cost that is more than the $5,000, so we would have to get two more quotes to consider moving forward on that project.
Does that include getting rid of the mold and what do they do to the, what's the process? What do they do?
The process is that they go in and they're going to lay a stone base, which would capture all the water.
Crushed stone?
Yeah, mm-hmm. And then they have, they seal the wall with proprietary materials that is magical and amazing, that never molds, never does anything, completely seals the basement in, and then any water comes down and gets caught in the bottom and drains out to a new sump pump that they, is a very much bigger sump pump and motor than you can, that we have right now, and is rated for.
Do they have a backup sump pump as well?
They don't have a backup, but they have a, if I remember correctly, because this was weeks ago.
An alarm system or something?
Right. There's different levels of things you can have. Depends on, right, we don't have a generator and a backup electric, but their pump will run for X amount of time beforehand and then has some sort of alert function involved with it that would let one of us know, and also their company, that something is going on that shouldn't be, if there was ever excessive amounts of water. It is not guaranteed if the entire area floods. they don't guarantee.
Makes sense.
Water goes water right comes, down the stairs.
Right, that they don't guarantee, but if it should be that nothing would come in from the sides.
So if we did this basement drying, then we might do another mold test to see if we needed to do mold abatement, it seems to me.
Basically, what the description of the project would be is that they do some cleaning, but they just seal the entire basement, and so nothing else would grow, and no water would be left to continue growth. Does sound.
And there wouldn't be wooden pallets there that are sitting in the water as a medium for mold to grow on?
Right, which is mainly our problem, that there is some, that it's just not designed to be, have a little stream running through it.
Well, I think that sounds more hopeful than I thought. I would encourage you to get two more quotes and see, but I'm going to look around the board. What would you, how do you want to respond to this, if anyway, this item 8 or 9, 8?
Well, I mean, I've worked with them a lot, you know, with
have you?
In real estate. Uh-huh. But what's good about their system is that, you know, you get this sort of lifetime warranty, and there's like a certain code number for it. So, I mean, it's not as relevant for us, but, you know, it, no matter who owns the property, the warranty stays. So, you know, if someone does it to their house and they sell the house a few years later, the new owner would still have the right to have them come and do stuff. That's not as relevant for us, but, you know, if you decide to move to, you know, somewhere else. But
I didn't know it would be possible to dry out the basement, so I'm impressed.
Where are we getting the money for this? Is that from our capital assigned and appropriated funds or something? Where's that? Where do we have $14,000 hanging around? Because it's not in our budget, correct?
That's right.
It's not.
No. We have to amend the budget? No, that's next year. So do we, where are we going to get this money?
Are there any grants or anything like this?
There might be. I haven't looked into that. I'm more confident about moving forward with some sort of basement drying than a mold remediation that doesn't actually
do anything.
I mean, it should do something, but it doesn't seem like it would have the guarantee like this.
I think it's going to be hard to get two quotes to do the same thing.
I think
other companies have other approaches.
Right.
But you can still get, I guess, a quote for their approach, and then the board could evaluate.
Right.
I mean, it would be a way of treating water in the basement. It might not be the exact same technique,
right.
But it seems to me those would qualify as comparable quote.
Mm-hmm. This quote is good for a year. I talked to him. I said, you know, what happens if we didn't do anything because we didn't since 1999 and we haven't floated away yet. But he said that that is the foundation of our building. Right now it does hold our electric panels and our heat. And it is, part of it is cinder block and part of it is the old foundation. If we keep the foundation in good shape, it will be better, easier to maintain and build or renovate in the future.
And so regardless of what we do with this building in the future, we would still have that basement and foundation.
Right. I've only been down there a couple times, but it's been years. It's not really a very big space. It's just where the furnace is. It's that little rectangle at the bottom of the stairs.
Yes.
It doesn't really...
It's tiny. There's nothing here, under there, under the art books room. Is all dry crawl space. So it's good in that it's small, because he does charge by the square foot of space. And I think that it would be good for us to continue to look for quotes and see what other options we have. And when we have more information, then determine if it's worth the expenditure. We do have some money in the capital funds. We don't have money lying around, throw in the basement, but if it's important.
The general answer to your question can be found on the statement.
Mm-hmm.
And either on the last page it says that it shows that the assigned unappropriated funds and the unassigned funds, there's money in those, which a couple of months ago we talked about where they might go, and we've just decreased the assigned appropriated funds by $30,000 almost for the compensated absences. But there is some fund balance that is available for whatever the board decides is the most important thing. And the board might decide that if we got through the summer without adding the air conditioning, we might try and put that off for a while. We have to decide each time an important decision comes to us, but the possibility of drying out the basement seems to me an important thing to get a serious move on.
Oh yeah, I was just curious about the money. I mean, our electrical panels and our furnace that are down there, seems like it's proactive to dry out the basement.
And perhaps even a more long-term solution than doing a mold remediation.
Yes. And when you talk about the air conditioners, do you mean the heat pumps?
Mm-hmm. I do. Which don't seem to have gotten installed yet, and yet it's still, the library has been bearable when I come in with the temporary air conditioners we have, and I expect that we'll hear more about the heat pumps, if not in this director's report, in another one. So anyhow, money, money is there to be allocated.
I have another question about the basement. Is there any part of the foundation that's rotting as a result of the water over a period of time?
I didn't get that from him. But I don't think that's necessary. Well,
that's important because if we were to seal it with rotting wood underneath, that's not good.
Well, this... No wood. It's laid stone and it's concrete, but is it
in terrible shape? No. Is it leaking? Yes. Is there water in the basement? Yes. Is it our foundation? Yes. Is the cost, you know, has doubled since 1999? Is it just going to keep going up? Probably. If we're going to be renovating this building and keeping that basement, are we going to want to have it be a good foundation to continue to build on? Yes. But I don't know if we should necessarily go ahead with doing the basement waterproofing versus the air conditioning heat pumps. I mean, that's a discussion that we're going to have at some point, unless we can come up with grant monies and other such things to make all things possible.
And things that might not be possible this year might next,
mm-hmm.
with other grants or other
right.
Fundraising mm-hmm. or capital campaigns or who knows.
Right.
Thanks.
So you're going to get two more bids?
I will work on it. Parking lot lining has been scheduled for Monday, August 31st. Again, that's the parking lot, parking spaces on this side, and the parking spaces in front of the laundromat. Not Vince's parking spaces. I'm working with the town on hopefully procuring the handicap signs, but I haven't heard back from them yet. The cost of the lining is $550, and as he said when he did the estimate, it's like you get one or two new parking spaces because people can actually
mm-hmm.
fit, which is nice. And I'm going ahead and putting the other handicap space in.
Mm, we'll paint it in.
Yes.
So it will have something like a sign.
Mm-hmm. And that'll be done before the election.
Terrific.
Repairs to the Booker Barn roof have been made. We talked about that. Roger and Philip did the work. The total cost was just under
$17,000.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Rather. Nobody would have approved that.
God, we saved a lot of money there.
Yeah.
And the Friends of the Library reorganized the big boards. They are now affixed to the former laundromat and will stay there until we come up with a demolition plan. It's been really interesting to watch as things develop on the chalkboard and get written and drawn and then get washed away. And mm-hmm. tourists come and take their pictures and
oh, great.
Peruse the goings-on. It's
cool. It also looks very nice now when you enter in the library that you don't have that really cluttered foyer with, like, 5 million notices.
Mm-hmm. Some people yeah. miss it. I
mm-hmm. that went well.
I find it that we need to find another space for the notices than the front foyer because it was just a traffic jam and wasn't a good use of space or a good space for people to be able to see all of the options.
Okay.
So we may come up with a different plan for when it gets cold, but the Friends and the library staff have been keeping the notices up to date and not falling on the ground and blowing
yeah.
away, so it's working all right.
Well, when we're talking about demolishing the laundromat pretty soon, right?
I'm working on it.
I just mean, like, by the time it gets really cold, the laundromat may not be
there. It may not be there.
Where are we going to store the stuff that's being stored in the laundromat? It's become a warehouse.
It's a little bit, but we can get rid of things.
Hmm?
We like the metal folding chairs are in there still because I haven't given them away to a good organization or donated them to Restore yet, and we'll find a place, or we don't need it. And also the book barn is going to be on winter hiatus soon. Well, not soon, but eventually. Go going on. Holly has been moved, has been hired as Linda's replacement as full-time clerk, and has been appointed by civil service, and her salary is $12.50 an hour, and I've gotten her in the New York State retirement system and will be joining our health insurance coverage as of September 1st. And I'm excited because she's great and we already have her and now we just have her more. I've also hired Kim Aquilant. She started on Tuesday and is excited to be here and seems to be fitting in well. Her salary is $12 an hour. And I believe the board needs to approve both of those appointments if you choose to. Do you have any questions about it?
Entertain a motion to...
Oh, we already did.
Well, this is a change from what we approved before.
She was part-time and now she's full-time. Because I...
Oh, okay.
Yeah. No. It's a change in...
It was Linda.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you approve Linda being the new Thomas and Holly's the new Linda.
Okay.
And Kim is the new
Holly. And Kim is the new Holly. Yep.
So,
all right.
Do we have to have two motions or it can be one?
No, I think it can be one motion.
Okay, I'd like to make a motion to approve Holly Ferrara's upgrade and Kim's appointment.
Thank you. Is there a second for that?
I'll second it.
Thank you, Dorothea. Any further discussion? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. The motion carries. Does that mean that we're fully staffed now, except for a director?
You got it.
Terrific.
Except for that one little thing.
Just a director. 14, Betsy Massey, who was filling in hours because we were short-staffed, has finished today her temporary work. We appreciated her very much, and she was wonderful. I am going to recommend to the new director that we kind of keep her on call as a substitute. Oh my gosh, everybody has bird flu or something like that. Since we've already had it. And I wanted to say that library staff have worked really hard this summer. They've done a whole lot of work. They've switched hours. They've stayed later occasionally when things just didn't work, and taken on new tasks, and all of them, Leslie Saho, Linda McAteer, Laura Pepitone, Holly Ferrara, Betsy Massey, and Limoy Lee have really deserve lots of commendations and rounds of applause. Mm-hmm. I wanted that to be in my report. Also, the library will be closed Saturday, September 5th, for Labor Day weekend, after we pass our budget. And also, I have signed the library up to participate in National Voter Registration Day, which is September 22nd, 2015. It's a national effort to ensure anyone who wants to can be registered to vote. It's not about any particular party or candidate or anything like that. We do right now have and always always had voter registration forms from the Board of Elections. I clarified with them that we can collect them here, so if anybody wants to register to vote at any time, we could do that.
Do they include, can people include a party designation when they register?
Oh, yeah.
What about if people are already registered and they just want to identify with a party?
That is the same form.
Okay, great.
You just resubmit it. Yeah.
Because the deadline is October 6th or something for people who want to vote in the primaries next April.
Right. The September
primaries.
Yeah, September 22nd. We'll definitely get people in before that date. So, I'm gonna be getting a toolkit with promotional materials from the National Voter Registration Organization, and we'll be looking for volunteers to help. I sort of think it'll be a table here in the library or outside if it's nice and whatnot, but if we can get any other groups or people involved.
And get an article in the Woodstock Times the week before.
Sure.
What a good idea, Barb. Yeah.
And so that's what's been going on with the library.
Sheesh.
Excuse me, I need to leave. I'm sorry. Okay.
Barry. See you, Barry.
Bye.
Bye. Fabulous.
Any more questions or comments for the director?
And you have a week's vacation during this month, too.
It was almost
pretty amazing.
Almost.
It's good. It was great. And some sunshine.
So, for committee reports, the director of research continues. We have narrowed it down to a short list of two candidates, and I hope we have a result before long. Planning committee.
We're on hiatus.
Public relations committee.
We're not on hiatus. The letters have been going to the paper every week. Jesse is going to be writing the letter for this coming week. And I made up a sign-up list for the farmer's market. We're going to be there on the 2nd, the day before the vote. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it's from 3:30 to 7:30, 7 o'clock or so. So I'm going to pass this around. I'll be there all afternoon. Anybody that's on the board that wants to come and sit is more than welcome. So I'm going to pass this around. Show number 26 is up on the internet. I don't know how many people have seen it, but it was very, very labor-intensive for me to do. Yeah. I did something I've never done before. I did two montages. One was of the library fair, doing video and then putting music underneath it. And I culled down about an hour's worth of videotape to 8 minutes. So that was pretty intensive to do. And I took probably, I think there were 54 photographs of all the services in the library, ranging from the first picture is Craig Barber holding his library card in his bag, starting with that, and then showing books, children's programs, children's events, writing groups, poetry groups, a lot of children's stuff. In both the video and the photographic montage, because there are, if anybody's been to the library fair, there were a lot of kids here this year. I think the most I've ever seen. Mm. And this is the future of our library. This is the future of our town, these kids. So I was trying to show that and inspire people to come out and vote for the budget because we need it. And so if you haven't seen it, please, you know, try to watch it. It's only 22 minutes long, and it's very nice. And I'm starting to work on the next show, and I'll put it out there again. If anybody knows anybody who reads and wants to be part of, you bet your life, no.
Knows how to read or does read.
Who knows how to read.
Who has time to read.
But doesn't read. I'd like to do an interview with them for what book are you reading? I'm always looking for people. Oh, what book are you writing? Matter of fact, next week I'm going to be videotaping Mackenzie Willis, who is a member of the Friends, who wrote a children's book. So I'm going to interview him here, and he's going to be on an upcoming show. But I'm looking for people who read, people who write, that want to be interviewed. Leave their names with Jessica. Or somewhere, you know, leave it here in the library, and I'll get back to them. I'll set up a time to go in and videotape them. That's about it.
Thanks, Barry.
Also,
thanks.
In public relations, we've been sending out quite a few more.
The card.
That too. Email notices and
yes.
And I've gotten board members and patrons saying that they appreciate the more information.
Yeah,
it's
definitely good.
Oh, I forgot to mention that the card, the budget card, is going to be going out.
The friends do every year, and Barry helped
they pay
them
for
design
that.
It. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Great. Thank you.
And it's going to all registered.
Well, I made a statement before about we have, I guess, 800 or 1,000 names in our database at the printer. So what we do is we send them the card, and then they just put the address. It's in the database. They just print them out with
the
address.
Actually,
this
goes to all registered voters. They do combine if people live in the same household, but it's about 3,500.
Right.
Or a little less.
Is that always 3,500?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So that's why we're going to have a voter registration day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Try and get it up. Thanks. How about on the policy front? Elaine, Barry?
I think it's time for a new policy. Or an update.
Don't you?
Well, we've given ourselves a vacation up to this point.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're filling in our time with other things.
Yes. Yeah, we've been busy with interviews and whatnot.
Just getting a tan and taking it easy.
So personnel is also on hiatus. Anything about the building you haven't already told us?
I hope not.
I didn't tell you about the AC and heat pumps because I'm still waiting for some information and
unchanged.
Right.
Okay.
But otherwise it still stands.
Yes.
Okay. Outreach. I know that you've been active.
Yes. No hiatus for the outreach committee. We have a very committed group of people. We started doing a brainstorming at our last meeting that was led by Doug Hoffman on the committee, who does this kind of thing as a management consultant a lot, and we're going to continue at the next meeting. We're taking our mission and dividing it into activities that, you know, ideas we have for activities in all aspects of our mission. And at our next meeting on the 25th, Rebecca Smith-Aldrich will be there, and she's preparing a presentation on what some other libraries in the Mid-Hudson region have done in terms of community outreach and, you know, what things we might be able to learn from that. And also kind of advise us on some of the, you know, in terms of subtleties, in terms of what we can do as a committee versus the board versus the library, you know, and kind of clarify some of those relationships. Thank you.
Terrific.
Yeah.
Thanks for keeping that thing moving right along.
Thank you.
Appreciations.
I want to appreciate Jessica for being such a fabulous interim director.
Mm-hmm. And I want to, again, appreciate our staff because I couldn't do this alone.
No.
Are cookies in order or cake or anything? Would they like that? Or is everybody on a diet or something?
Well, the friends have started providing animal crackers and pretzels to us and anybody else who wants them, since we have a lack of Fritos. Since Thomas is single.
A lack of Fritos?
Yeah.
They're Thomas Fritos.
But lately we've been getting vegetables from people's gardens, so that makes us feel appreciated. There's also yellow squash in there if you want some.
That's always good for a midday snack, isn't it?
How about some broccoli?
Broccoli would be okay. I'd like to appreciate Stuart for all your thoughtful work, and you go to everything, you and Jessica. You've really organized this board and brought us through equally, same as Jessica, real tough waters, rough waters. So I appreciate all the hard work you've been doing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Especially when I'm just back from a vacation.
Yes.
Well, you deserved it.
And including the search for a new director, which is a lot of work. Mm.
Mm-hmm. Old business. I don't know of any old business. New business? Any new business? Public be heard. Ken? Nick? Hearing none, I'd entertain a motion to adjourn. Moved by Barry Miller, seconded by Dorothea to adjourn at 8:07.
Yeah, really?
Any further discussion? All in favor, aye. All opposed, nay. The motion carries.